I'm not for you.
Last year we came out with a record, and there's a song on that record that was inspired by a friend of mine named Gerald Clark, and he was deployed to Afghanistan where he served in the military, and was faced with a moment where a young man started to walk towards him with an IED strapped to his chest, and he had only a split second to decide if he would take this man's life or watch him and his friends die. So we pulled the trigger, but he didn't come home the same person that he left for. And when he got back, he told me this story and it inspired this song. It's called Panic Room. lustrous signs of skin, opaque blinds, frozen metacarpals, tap, tap, tap through window glass, syncopated staccatos with a broken clock, synchronized with my post-traumatic tits, tits, talking to the space in the room that echoes back indiscernibly to my disconnected self, self, it's self-consuming, what's it doing, it's my doing. So Cleveland / Lakewood, how are you doing? As some of you may know, this is the first time we've ever done a headlining tour, and it means the world that this room is full of people that want to listen to music. Thank you so much. Real quick, the first person who played today is an artist who's incredibly inspiring to us. She goes by Mini Rooms. Did anyone catch her? I hope you did, and if you didn't, please go home and check out Mini Rooms. It is beautiful, soul-tearing music. We love her so much. Thank you for playing with us, Bree. And after her were a few more bands from this era that played very, very well. A band called Iron Bison and Chasing Horizons. Give it up to them. And well, we're going to keep this going. This next one's called Wasteland Vichnust, and it goes out to our friends in a band called Ghost Key. I think you've heard of them. Winter 1946. This is a story about a lady named Julia Spasobra who defied the expectations of a culture and the desires of her government to give life to all people despite their race, their religion, or their gender. This is her story. For us, it's called Native Blood. Before we play this, I want to say something that I think our culture has become so politically divided and so fragmented that if you ever show empathy for a people group that is different than you or not American, all of a sudden it makes you something. Because the last time that I checked, humanity is about understanding people that are different than us and showing compassion to those who have little or have been overlooked throughout history. This is a song called Native Blood. The barren place breaks out on me. Let's go. Got to the cloud, leave me one. Then the arches I out, return to the sky for privileged perspective. Goodbye, goodbye. Return. It's all vicious pain on the day. You built your father's up. Borders are about strangled up. Come and die. These things of various people will be an end of time. Because the earth is just bad. If only it is to see it. Ignorance failure! Cause it sounds like your heartbeat keeping time! Then you turn and remind me that this pain has a purpose! And maybe we'll fall the same tonight! Thank you so much. It is really good to be back in Ohio. We're gonna play a new song that we've only played a few times. I wanna dedicate this to any person who's ever gone through depression or suicidal thoughts or has lost a loved one to suicide. This song's written about that. It's called Understanding Love Is Lost.
This one's for you, Bill.
Cleveland, are you still with us? There's like so many people in this room that are very near and dear to our heart. Even though we're from Los Angeles, a lot of times it kind of feels like we're from Ohio, and it means seriously, it really does. And so there's a few bands that are on tour with us right now, and the first of which I want to talk about once again is a band called Ghost Key. Please give it up for them. We had the privilege of touring with them about a year ago, along with our friends in Beartooth, and seeing Ghost Key play every single night, really just the emotion and the message that they bring struck us. So when we got to go do this, it was kind of a no-brainer to be able to tour with Ghost Key. They came out with a new record a few days ago, and I really, really encourage you to pick it up. It's a very good record. Please check that out. There's another band we're on tour with that we've been playing shows with since, 2012. A band called Dayseeker. Give it up to Dayseeker. Love those dudes, and I'm super stoked that they're still not so sick of us that they can tour with us. And then a band that just played right before us is a band called Hail the Sun. And they're way too talented. We don't even belong on the same stage as them, but they decided to come out on tour with us, and we appreciate that eternally. We're going to play a couple more. This is a song called Tiny Hands, Au Revoir. In the summer of 1944, Nazi troops would march into this small French village called Oradour-sur-Glane. They shot the men, then took the women and children into a church where they burned it down. One lady named Madame Rafalcha survived and gave this testimony at the war trials. This is Tiny Hands, Au Revoir. One. This song is about extending hospitality to those on the other side of the world in need. This song is about being taught not to fear but to love. It's called Orphan.
Our advances spark a flame from God's love.
Y'all still with us? See, I'm not really one for like a rehearsed stage persona. Like I'm this tough guy who says the same thing every night. And actually, most nights of this tour, though, I have shared something that I want to share with you. Because before we play this song, I would feel remiss if I did not. Last summer, we were on our way back to Los Angeles, and we played a show in Lawrence. And I got to talk to a lot of people, and if you know much about us, you know that we love relationships and we love getting to know y'all. And after most of the room had cleared out, there was a young lady sitting on the stage, and she said she wanted to talk. So we chatted for a little bit, and I asked her what was going on, and she said that she felt completely numb inside. And when I asked her to kind of explain what she meant by that, she said she couldn't remember the last time that she was happy or sad or felt anything short of just nothing. She felt completely empty. And so I tried to throw some words at it and thought about stuff that I've read in textbooks and advice that friends had given me. And everything that I said felt honestly quite petty. I don't feel like it meant much. I don't know if she heard it. I don't know. Maybe my words sucked. But it went nowhere. And after a while, you know, we prayed and she left. And she didn't leave my head. A few months later, I got a message from her older brother on Twitter, and he said, "Hey, just so you know, my sister who you talked to this summer, she took her life last night. And I don't understand how we can live in a world where an 18-year-old girl about to finish high school and go out into the world and do whatever she wants with her life decided that she would rather die than live another day on this earth completely healthy and lives in a place where she's free. She can't live anymore." And it always reminds me that people all live in their own realities. And a lot of times you can go through life thinking your coworkers or your friends or your family that you actually know what's going on. And you can go months without having a real conversation with someone and just assume that because they smiled or because they said they're doing fine, that they're actually doing fine. But so often that's not really the case.
And I don't tell you this story to get you bummed out. I tell you this story so that you can do something about that. So that the next time you see someone that you love and you feel that love for them, that you act on it and you ask them how they're doing. Because you'd be very, very surprised to find out the lives of that people are actually living inside. As a therapist, I would sit and talk with people who had, you know, boyfriends, girlfriends, so many friends and family that loved them. And they would be like, I feel completely alone and I don't think anyone cares about the shit that I'm going through in my life. So I just want to say, wherever you're at tonight, whether you're someone who feels like you could be talking to a loved one or you feel like someone needs to talk to you, I just want to encourage you to think and to look past the walls that people put up and to try empathizing with others. When you see someone who you think is the worst person on earth, a lot of times I find that if you know why that person is the way they are, if you hear their story and you find out exactly what makes them so angry or so awful, it's hard to hate them. It's hard to hold hate to someone that you love. So I just want to say thank you so much for coming out to this tour. And before we play this next one, please look past the walls that people put up. We love y'all. We're going to play a new one. This song's called Nervosa. I wrote this song while being a therapist for a young lady who had an eating disorder. I spent about 9 months with her, and over that period of 9 months, I watched as her perceptions of herself ate away till there was very little left of her body. I want to dedicate this song to anyone who's going through an eating disorder, has gone through an eating disorder, or has a family or friend, because there's love and there's healing in community.
Of course.
We're going to play another new one. This song's called Psych Escape. Goes out to our friends from Columbus, Ohio. Cleveland. We have one more song for you, and for the sake of transparency, I'm going to tell you that this song was written about the time that I was diagnosed with bipolar personality disorder and tried to take my own life. And after everything that I'd read in books and everything that I thought I knew, I became completely and utterly humbled by the lack of control that I had in my own mind. So we wrote this song. This song's called Depths 2. My head cocked sideways in confusion. As my looking glass became a two-way mirror, and you could watch behind from everything on this living sphere. And don't you dare darken my doorstep, stranger. Never step more. Oh no, never more! You see, I have this reoccurring dream where we snuck past scores of slumbering guards and fixed that rusted iron key that locked to set you free. Cause I would bring you liberty, bring reality of a coward. I'm collateral matter, swayed by the banalities of time and space. I'm a name without a face. Intrepidation recharged all my terror turned to madness. When I awoke, I was swinging in shrouded silhouettes. And I stumbled out the door, and my anger was extinguished by this downpour. Compelled, void of volition, my steps propelled me through this chronic storm. Right there in the clearing, through the gaps in the trees, to dark smoke flickered from far, illuminated by an ease. The clockwork, seven sisters turned together in a circle. Autonomy's abandoned, moved singular and perpetual. Round the dark blue flame, where I heard you call my name. Cause I'm the fire that is never quenched, and I'm the river that will not run dry. And when I slept in that garden, let's play one more song. Are y'all still with us? I remember playing this venue. There's a guy in here named Corey Haiti. Corey, where are you? He's somewhere around here. I don't know. Maybe he's not inside. There's a guy named Corey Haiti, and he makes these shows possible. He throws a lot of the shows in Cleveland and Columbus. He's also our manager. Just want to give it up to Corey, right, real quick. I think Corey threw us a show here like a year and maybe some change ago, and there was like probably 30 people. And so there's more than 30 people tonight, and that really warms my heart, seriously. Thank you so much for coming out. Give it up to yourself. We're gonna play one more. This is an older one. It's very close to our hearts. It's called Dark Strand, Hibakusha. And again, I believe that we're measured as humans by our ability to empathize and care for those who can give us nothing, those who we fear, those who we do not understand. August 6th, August 9th, 1945, Hiroshima, Nagasaki. Thank you. 5 words. Will you wait for me?
We'll be hanging out. I'll be here to talk, pray, chat, whatever y'all want to do. This means the world to us. Give it up to yourselves.